In the first lesson of this little section here, we're going to talk about the most important part of our project, and that is the planning. We want to make sure that we know what's needed. We're going to determine the scope of the job. We'll draw us up a plan. We'll go through and measure everything that we need to know. We'll find a water source that that we know what the pressure and flow is. And then we're going to check our numbers. We'll consult with the book and determine that we know what we're doing. And then we'll write up a parts list. So let's take a look at the job and understand, you know, what we're looking at here. And we're doing a backyard renovation. And this is the backyard of my personal home. And as you see here, I'm kind of scanning across the backyard, and you can see that there's some untouched things or some unfinished projects on the deck here. But there's three big pots on the backyard that we want to put drippers in. We've got this gazebo that we're going to do hanging baskets from. And this is just a picture of some cheap plastic baskets hanging there, but we'll do some nicer ones. And we're also going to run some drip line around the outside edge of this gazebo and take care of this row of Mondo grass and cast iron plants. And then on the outside of the gazebo, there's about five or six camellias there that don't have any irrigation on them. And we're going to drop just a little bit of loop around this Lenten rose inside this walkway here. So let's draw us up a plan. We need to know how everything is going to lay out. And it's always good if you're going to be presenting a quote to your customer that you have something written up, that you're just not flying by the seat of your pants or just pulling something out of your head. So always take a few minutes and just sketch everything out. And here, you know, I just go through and get my details together, and we're going to look through our Rainbird Manufacturer's product catalog and get all of our numbers and everything from that. And we're going to show you, you know, how that fits together. But let's first measure up all of the places that we're going to put our drip line. Now, I've got a good place in mind for our water source, and this is actually the lowest head in this zone, but it works out really well as far as location. Now, what I did when I was putting all this together, I want to put a gauge on here and make sure that we know what our pressure is. We're well over 80 PSI here, nearly 90 PSI. So with that, we know for sure that we're going to need a pressure reducing filter on this setup here. But we know that we've got plenty of flow available because the zone isn't using that much. It's only got three heads on it, and it's using 8 gallons per minute on a 15 gallon per minute supply. So we have about 7 gallons per minute to work with. So now here I am just going through, and what I need to know from the book is what the maximum length of a lateral line, you know, off of a single supply source will go, and that's 230 feet. And we also need to know what the flow per 100 feet of our drip line is going to be. So as we look through our product catalog here, you need to know the exact product that you're going to use. We're using a Rainbird XFD with a 0.9 gallon per hour at a 12-inch spacing. So we have all of our figures here, and that's going to allow us to know in advance whether our supply is going to give us enough water to take care of the entire project. So obviously we have our gazebo here with hanging baskets and drip line that goes around the outside of 85 feet. And then for the camellias around that left side, we have another 85 feet of drip line. Our little areas inside the walkway, I'm only going to use a 10-foot loop there, and then our loop around our holly tree is going to be an 18-foot loop. And I connected that up with a solid drip tubing. So when we add everything up, our total drip line that we're going to use is 198 feet, and that adds up to 3.06 gallons per minute. So we know that that's inside of the 4 gallons per minute that we're typically constrained to on a half inch supply source. But when we look at our source, we've measured 85 PSI, and we know that we have 7 gallons per minute left from what I just told you, a 15 gallon per minute source. And so we have 4 gallons per minute at our half inch fitting. So some of the other things that I measured here was the elevation rise for our hanging baskets to make sure that there was enough pressure in the line to push the water all the way up into the drippers. Our zone run time is 30 minutes, and that's going to inform us as to what size of drippers that we need to put on our baskets. And here I've calculated up our flow demand for the hanging baskets. We've got 7 drippers at 2 gallon per hour each. Our potted plants, we have 3 plants that we're going to use 2 gallon per hour drippers, and 1 plant that we're going to use a 1 gallon per hour dripper. It was the smaller pot with the basil in it. And so our total flow demand for this project is going to be 3.4 gallons per minute. And so we can run all of this from a single source. We know that our limit on half inch tubing and a half inch connection is 4 gallons per minute. So we're within that. So we're definitely on the good side here, but this is a smaller project. Sometimes when you get into a whole lot of drip line and a lot of pots, it's easy to overextend your demand for flow. And a lot of times people get confused about this. I hope you understand water hydraulics, that there's a difference between pressure and flow. And a lot of times when people run out of water, they blame it on not enough pressure. Usually it's an issue of them over demanding flow for that project. And of course, we're going to generate a parts list as we go along so that we can have all this stuff on hand when we show up to our project and be able to get everything done without running back and forth to the supply house.